YouTube, what is going on? Back my latest video, back in the installment of Speculation Saturdays. So today I'm gonna talk to you guys about six Funko Pops from FunkoCon that I think could be future grails. This has always been one of my most favorite segments on this Speculation Saturdays time, is to talk about future cons and what I think it's gonna end up being a future grail. It's fun for me, hopefully it's fun for you, so let's get right into it, see what I think. Here we go. Alright guys, before we get into this video, please smash that like button down below. Let me know you guys are enjoying these videos, and as always, if you're new to this channel, welcome, hit subscribe button down below as well so you're updated to my most recent content, and hit that bell notification so you're alerted as soon as I post a new video. So before we get into this, what I like to try to do every Saturday is I like to talk about the financial side of Funko Pops, you know, different topics, and also suggest Funko Pops that I think may go up in value over time. This segment's not intended to inflate value, so before people get mad at me for possibly getting these pops to sell out, that's not my intention at all. Just based on future data, it's gonna happen anyways. I just wanna let you guys know so that maybe you're able to kinda hone in and focus on these pops before they sell out. Now, before we get into those pops, I know a lot of people have asked me my opinion on FunkoCon, which pops I like, what I think about overall with the con, and so on and so forth. So if you follow me on Instagram, you know already that I am not excited at all about this convention. There are only a few pops that I even want in my collection, and I'll let you guys know that in a couple seconds. But in general, just wasn't excited at all. Now, I don't know if that's because I've been a lot more picky with the Funko Pops I am adding to my collection, or if when I really got into the Funko games, Comic Cons were a little bit more special. And what I mean by that is, back in the day, you know, I sound like an old guy right now, but conventions were seemed to be for certain characters. They kind of were holding off on a line and then were releasing it for the con as like an exclusive thing. Like, you had to, in order to complete the line, get that character or a different character in like a extremely popular costume for the moment. And it seems like they're just recycling a whole lot of characters or not making any special characters for this convention, outside of a few. So I see a lot of recycled characters, a lot of characters I'll talk about that I don't know who they are at all. And it just kind of seemed lackluster to me. That's just my personal opinion, just based on previous cons. The last few ones that have happened, this has been the least exciting one to me. But let me know what you guys thought in the comment section below, what you guys thought about overall about the con. And let's get right into my thoughts about these Funko Pops. So I'm just gonna zoom through them real quick, looking at the list right here. I'll put it up on the screen so you guys can see it as well. So we always get a Harry Potter pop. You know, I'm not buying that one. It's from a scene in the movie that I remember from the book as well. I don't think it was really worth making to a Funko Pop, but I think they have a deal with J.K. Rowling or Harry Potter Studios or whatever, that they have to put a Harry Potter Pop out every year for convention. I think they could have done a different one. There's still some characters from there we haven't gotten, but I digress. FYE has some pretty cool things. The Dr. Fate, I won't be getting. I'm not a huge DC guy, but that Leslie, Filibuster Leslie, may or may not get it, probably won't, but definitely for anybody who's a Parks and Recreation fan, that's a, you know, a pretty important episode. I can see why people would want it. Walgreens has Blade. It's a repeat character. I think the reason why they're doing it is because Blade's getting a movie or TV show, forget which one, and you know, in Fortnite, I believe, as well. So popular character again. Don't know why they need to remake a character like that for Comic-Con when they can just make a line. But, you know, nonetheless, they did what they did. Now, Box Lunch has some sleepers. I know a lot of people weren't really excited about the Box Lunch pops. That wardrobe from Beating the Beast actually looked to be pretty nice. I probably will get it, you know, just being a Disney collector. The Kronk, I wasn't too excited about, just because they just came out one for WonderCon that I thought was better. And I think this is actually the more desirable version of Kronk, because he had his own show too, I believe, and that was one that's a little bit more memorable. But it kind of doesn't hit as hard when you have so many of the same character coming out over and over again. It's just recycling the characters Funko's been doing recently kind of makes it less special. Let me know what you guys think about that. Walmart has a Crash Bandicoot that I think is really cool, but I have one Crash in my collection, that's enough for me. You have the It's a Small World pop, which is weird. I don't think that line performed very well, so to have a convention exclusive is pretty weird. And then I think this is G.I. Joe pop, which is probably gonna be pretty popular of all the Walmart ones. I don't think it necessarily will sell out or not, but it's definitely a cool one. Amazon has that Three Musketeers, Mickey Mouse, which is cool, the Wolfman Captain America. I'm not a Captain America fan at all, so I won't be picking that up. Got Star Wars Pop, and you got Black Noir, which is pretty cool, but he looks just like Snake Eyes, so I won't be picking that one up. Although The Boys, if you guys have not seen it, it's a very, very dope show. You definitely should check that out. Don't show your kids it, though, because it's definitely not for kids. Now we have Target, which has, I don't even know who this is, I think it's Deathstroke, maybe. They have a Transformers Pop, which is pretty cool. I think a Shockwave. I'm not a big Transformers guy, so I can't really speak on if that one's going to be really good or not, but it's a Target Pop. They tend to do pretty well, so if you want that one, I definitely would pick it up. There's a Falcon Pop and also a Pokemon Pop as usual. So a lot of cool things, you know, here. You got the Hot Topic Pops, which is a lot of cool things. The McNuggets, though, is terrible. I don't know if I'm the only one that thinks this. I think the McNuggets don't translate well to Funko Pops. I understand why they did it. I'm not mad at Funko at all for doing a lot of different versions of it as well. I just don't think they look good. I'm 100% behind the idea of doing it. They just don't look good. So let me know what you guys thought about that. The weirdest Funko Pop, though, for them to do, it's two that I think are weird, and they both were Funko Shop exclusives. We have the Rocketeer, which I'm baffled by them making another Rocketeer Pop. I don't believe that movie's that popular. Let me know if I'm wrong. I have the original Rocketeer up there somewhere, and I thought that was good enough for it, but it looks like they revisited it, and it's not too different of a pose that was worth making into convention exclusive. But you know, definitely for somebody that wants it, they're able to get a cheaper price now if they're able to get it for retail. And the other one that was pretty weird was that Seal, the Sugar Smack Seal. I've never seen that guy before. I grew up eating Sugar Smacks with Diggum Frog, and I've never ever seen that seal ever before in my life. So if you guys have seen that seal, let me know in the comment section below. But I thought it was a really weird one. I won't be picking it up. I'm not gonna try to be completionist and keep my ad icon set complete with things I don't remember anymore. And that one's definitely not one I remember. But let me get right into the pops I think could be future grails. There are six of them that I think could be future grails. To be quite honest with you guys, I don't think any of these have huge potential at all. These are just the six I think have the most potential. If you're looking to spend your money and invest your money in Funko Pops, I think your money is better suited elsewhere. Definitely check out my other videos. I've now done, as of last week, 52 of these segments. So that's 52 weeks of financial advice for Funko Pops. Check them all out. There's a playlist on my channel where you can check out advice. I think your money's better suited there than any of these Funko Pops if you're looking to invest in them. If you're looking to buy what you like, by all means, do that. I think there's some cool things for every single niche and collector in this con. I just think it was lackluster, but there is at least something for everybody, so just buy what you like. But these are the six Funko Pops I think have potential to go up in value. So up first, we have the two Pokemon ones, the Diamond Bulbasaur and the Diamond Squirtle. I am tired of Funko making Flocked or Diamond versions for cons. I wish they would make some exclusive ones. Like if Charizard had been not a common, had been in a convention exclusive, it'd been very, very dope. I understand why they didn't do it. It was definitely a money reason. They want to make as many of those Charizards as possible because they're going to sell no matter what. So I get it, but hopefully down the line, once they at some point gotten too many of these things Flocked and Diamond out, they start putting exclusive Pokemon into these con slots, I think it'd be very cool. But either way, they tend to sell for whatever reason. I think it just kind of goes into a different market as well. Pokemon's a huge collecting hobby, as you guys saw this year, last year. I think these people outside of Funko community are gonna want these, and I think that always tends to make these exclusive ones go up higher. So if you want these, the Bulbasaur is at Target, and the Squirtle is at GameStop. So if you want them, definitely ones I would try to get for retail. They're definitely gonna be worth more than retail and probably future grails down the line, like some of the other ones. I think the Jolteon and Vaporeon ones from the last convention, definitely the Vaporeon went up. So I definitely would get those ones. I think they're definitely destined to be at least more than their $15 convention retail price. Up next, we have the two My Hero Academia Pops. I think they are fire. Now, I know a lot of My Hero Academia fans were upset about the initial release. They thought the Gang Orca was ugly. To me, he looks like Gang Orca, and Gang Orca is an ugly looking character, but I think that's what makes him great. I have no problems with him personally, and I don't think many other people will, especially as being this the only gang Orca Pop you're gonna get. So if there's, you're a fan of the show, fan of the character, people are gonna get this one, and it's a limited pop because it's a convention exclusive. So that pop's releasing at Hot Topic. I definitely would get that one if you're looking to add to your collection. I think it's gonna be the first one to sell out for Hot Topic. That the Mongo, I think his name is, from Samurai Jack, it's pretty cool. The Sinestro's cool from Hot Topic. But I think the gang Orca's gonna be the first one to sell out there. Again, I could be wrong, this is all predictions. This is kind of me freestyling and going off my best guess, so don't hold me to these, but they tend to, you know, actually pretty, work out pretty well in the long run. But that gang Orca to me is a very, very cool looking Funko Pop. And then we have Fat Gum that's releasing at GameStop. So initially, I don't know if you guys know, because a lot of people thought this was gonna be a 4-inch pop. It was circulating around the internet that it was only a 4-inch pop. It is actually a 6-inch pop, so I think a lot of people are going to be excited about that. It being a 6-inch pop is kind of true to size, how he was on the show, and I think people are going to get that one very quickly. So honestly, I think GameStop has probably the best pops from the convention. I know a lot of people are excited about the Samurai, what's his name? Stanley, from The Office. And also that Homer Simpson one. I won't be getting it. I just don't need it. I have enough Homers in my collection. That's a memorable scene from The Simpsons. I don't need it. A lot of people like it though. But that Fat Gum, I think, is one that's gonna sell out. 6-inch pops tend to have a lower ceiling than the regular ones, but sometimes they break out, and I think this is definitely a fan favorite from the show and definitely one you want to get before it's too late. So I definitely think those are two picks ups that you want to have that are definitely going to go above the retail price. So sticking with GameStop, another Funko Pop that I think is going to be a future grail just based on previous pops in this line is that, I think, Xanathar from Dungeons and Dragons. I think it's a cool looking pop. I don't know who he is at all, or she is, whatever. It's a cool looking character, all things considered. The last pop we got from GameStop for Emerald City Comic Con initially sat on shelves for a little bit, and then it's become a grail. So I can see that being the same case with this one. A lot of the other Dungeons and Dragons pops tend to have done that as well. So if you're looking to add that kind of pop to your collection, I definitely would do so. It's probably gonna sell out pretty quickly, and it kind of crosses over into other hobbies and collectibles as well. So definitely one you wanna get. I think it looks cool, and it's definitely gonna be one based on other trends. I think it's gonna end up being a future grail later down the line. Now, before I talk about the last one, because the last one's pretty obvious, just wanna highlight, there is other pops I think will go up above the retail price, like obviously the Master Universe ones from Toy Tokyo will, because I think they're gonna sell out pretty quickly. The show exclusive ones always are gonna be more than retail because they're so limited, but I don't see them having too much upside other than from where the Conde price is going to be, just because they're not characters I think people are really that excited about. The Galactus looks extremely dope, but there's other options for Galactus if you want a 10-inch pop for him. And I just think those ones are kind of obvious, and if you get them for retail, you get them for retail. That Walrus from Alice in Wonderland's pretty cool, but it's Entertainment Earth. They don't tend to go up too much, but I think it's still a pretty cool pop. And like I said, there's a lot of other ones that have potential, but these are just the six I think are going to not just peak at Conde. I think long term, we're talking about this next year, they're the six most likely ones to have gone up the most. So the last one I want to talk about is the Black Light White Rabbit from Funko Shop. That one is going to come down to how much people still care about Black Light. It tends to have a lot of resale value. The Alice in Wonderland pops that released on Funko sold out pretty quickly. It crashed the website, and if anybody wants to complete that set now, they're going to need that rabbit to complete their set. So that's one I think is gonna be very, very popular. He's a popular enough character, and Blacklight is extremely popular right now. So it's definitely gonna be probably the first one to sell out from the convention. So if you wanna get that, or from the Funko Shop, I should say. So if you wanna get that one, I would get that one first. It has the most long-term potential if Blacklight continues to be a thing, and for anybody that's trying to complete that Alice in Wonderland Blacklight collection. So like I said, it's not too much that I'm excited about. Those are just the six I think are the most likely to go up. Again, put your money better. There's a better place for your money than these convention exclusives, I think. Let you guys know which ones I want. I'm looking for the My Hero Academia pops. I want that Mubi, the cow from Jay and Silent Bob. I really like that pop. The Danger Mouse pop from Funko Shop, I really, really liked as well. And there was one more I liked. The Box Lunch wardrobe I might get as well. But honestly, and the walrus from Alice in Wonderland. There's not too much else that I really want. That's just my opinion, though. Let me know your guys' thoughts in the comment section below. This is just my opinion. There's not much research I can put into this like my other videos, so I'm just kind of freestyling and let you guys know what I think about this con and my opinion. So those are the six, though, I think are definitely going to go up in value. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. As always, thanks for watching. I appreciate your support, your opinions, and your support and love as always. Let me know your thoughts. If you have not already, hit that like button down below. Subscribe if you're new. Check me out on my second channel at Savage Breaks, where I do Pokemon and sport card openings. And check me out on my Instagram at ThePopSavage. You can stay connected there too. Thanks again for watching, guys. And until next time, I'll see you later.